Hey guys, welcome back. Apple announced new iPads this week, the iPad Gen 8 and the new iPad Air. The improvement to the iPad Gen 8 is the new A12 chip. But what I want to focus on today is the exciting new iPad Air and why it is finally, finally useful for students. This is the 4th generation iPad Air, and with this, Apple finally made the iPad Pros more affordable. They have made so many exciting upgrades to the iPad Air that I can't really tell the difference between the Pro and the Air. The most exciting upgrade to the Air is the Apple Pencil 2 support. Now, when I was a student, I owned the Gen 2 iPad Air. That was my previous iPad before the iPad Pro. And I always felt that the iPad Air was perfect for me. But my problem is, I never know when exactly to use it. It was always trapped in between the laptop and the phone. It was not as powerful as my laptop to completely replace it. And it was not as portable as my phone. So it was always idle on my desk, underused, severely underused. But I've been using the iPad Pro and the Apple Pencil for a while now, and trust me when I say this, the Apple Pencil is the best thing that happened to the iPads. The Apple Pencil is what makes the iPad super useful for school and for work, and it used to be exclusive to the iPad Pros. So just imagine my excitement when they said that the iPad Airs now support Apple Pencil 2. I'm just mind blown. So freaking excited for like students right now because they get to enjoy this with a more affordable iPad. And it works with the Magic Keyboard. So if you want to create a little touchscreen laptop setup with your iPad Air, you got that as well. On top of this, inside the iPad Air features the new A14 Bionic chip. This is the chip that will be powering the iPhone 12 that will be launched later this year. This is the industry's first 5-nanometer processor. Incredible. So it's basically Apple flexing in Intel's face. And apparently with this chip, now the iPad Air has a more advanced chip than the iPad Pros. What is exciting is that this is the first time ever that an iPhone chip is featured inside the iPads before the iPhone is launched because of COVID and all the delays in manufacturing and everything. USB-C is finally here for the new iPad Airs, and it is kind of weird that the Gen 8 iPads don't get that upgrade as well. It is still lightning charging. I mean, it would be nice that Apple changes its entire iPad lineup to have USB-C charging instead of like, you know, two having USB-C and the other one having the lightning charging. It's like very, very confusing for users. There's really nothing much that sets the iPad Air and iPad Pro apart, but note, there's no ProMotion 120Hz display in the iPad Air, and I'm someone who really appreciates the fast and very, very smooth refresh rate on the iPad Pros. So if that's something that matters to you, you would want to go with the Pro instead of the Air. But I can't imagine being a student and needing that really, really fast refresh rate. Unless you're a professional iPad gamer that needs that high refresh rate. Another thing is Touch ID lives on in the iPad Air. You won't be getting Face ID in the Airs, but Touch ID will be built into the on-off button here. And this tech was actually rumored to happen to future iPhones so that we can achieve that sweet bezel-less iPhones. So I'm actually kind of glad that they incorporated this into the Airs. It means that in future, we might really be getting like bezel-less iPhones with Touch ID embedded here. That would be like super cool. Oh, I can't wait for the bezel-less iPhones. Another thing new with the iPad Air is that there are 5 different colors for you to choose from. And I know that I would have been so happy to have all these choices if I were still a student and I had to bring the iPad Air around. Because colors show off your personality and it differentiates your iPads from other iPads. Blue or space gray would have been my pick. And now let's talk about price. Now this is a factor that is super important, and this is why I really think that the iPad Air is of such good value. The iPad Air is priced at $599, and this is $200 cheaper than the Pro. And if you were a student and you were to get the discount plus the full package, the Apple Pencil, Magic Keyboard, and the iPad, it adds up to about $947, slightly less than $1,000. And for me, if I were to convert it to my home currency, it adds to about 1.4K, and this is way cheaper than the 1.7K iPad Pro or MacBook Pros. but this adds up to $100 more than a baseline MacBook Air. However, overall, this is definitely much easier to recommend to students as compared to the super high-end iPad Pros. I think people might actually ask, why do we need a 1K machine to write, to draw, to take notes? I mean, don't we already have the paper and pen for that? And that is like way less expensive than the iPad Air, obviously. But I guess like it comes down to personal choice. I think some people, including myself, really, really like the paperless life, and the iPad is one of the best tablets out there in the market for all that writing, note-taking, scribbling, sketching, drawing, typing. And that, for some people, is a good enough replacement for the traditional old expensive laptop. I do see more students in school using iPads and tablets instead of laptops, and I'm pretty sure that the iPad Air is gonna be a very, very popular choice among students. And yeah, that's all my take for the iPad Air. I'm actually really, really happy and excited for students these days who get to enjoy all this cool, amazing, great tech at such an affordable pricing. I'm jealous, just a little bit. Makes me wanna be a student again, but nope, I'm not gonna be a student again, so yeah. But yeah, let me know what you think. I'm really curious. Do you think the iPad Air are worth getting, or do you wanna stick to the Pro, or do you want to stick to the traditional laptop? I mean, really, really curious? Let me know in the comments below. I hope this video helped some of you guys. And if you enjoyed this, like this video and subscribe for more videos like this. I'll see you guys really soon. Stay maintained, cheery. Bye-bye.